I lost my 2FA of my Discord account. I am trying to recover my Discord and this doesn't work. Funciona para conta do Discord. That's from my Portuguese viewers, but I get the point. Many of you have problems with accessing your Discord account under different circumstances. So in this video, we're going to address the problem and see all the options available to recover your Discord account if you lost your Authenticator app generating the 2FA codes or your phone number. So make sure to stick around till the end of this video to find out whether you can still recover your Discord account or not. Now, the first thing you want to check before you try any of the recovery ways I'm about to show you is to see whether you are still logged in on any of your devices. This could be your PC, tablet, smartphone, or whatever. If you are still logged in, you can easily access your 2FA backup codes from your account settings using your current password. So at this point, you can either use the codes to bypass the 2FA on any device you are trying to log in, or you can remove the 2FA completely and set it up again onto your mobile device using your preferred authenticator app. If this sounds complicated to you, I strongly recommend you to watch my previous video where I explain everything you need to know about the Google Authenticator, how to set it up and how to use the app. I do realize this is an ideal situation and probably most of the people having issues with their account do not have their Discord logged in onto another device. However, it's worth trying. The second thing you should do is head over to their website on discord.com and click on login. In here, you need to enter your account credentials like your email or phone number and your password, and then click on login. As you can see, you will be prompted to insert a 6-digit authentication code or an 8-digit backup code, which obviously you don't have since you deleted your authenticator app or lost your phone or whatever. Now, what you wanna do in this case is click on receive authentication code by SMS. So if you were precautious enough to set your phone number as a backup 2FA method, you're going to receive a code which you can use to log into your Discord account. This is a very common practice nowadays to add a phone number as a recovery way for your accounts, and I personally prefer doing this for every account that I intend using for a longer period of time. And I strongly recommend that you should do the same. So at this point, like I mentioned previously, you can remove the 2FA from your Discord account settings and set it up once again onto your mobile device using your preferred authenticator app. Some might ask, but what if my phone is broken? How can I receive the codes? Well, you can simply transfer your SIM card onto a different phone. Or what if my phone was lost or stolen? Well, if your phone number was registered to your name, you should be able to get a replacement SIM card with the same number from your phone carrier. If none of these work for you, the third thing you should try is search for any backup codes on your device. Now, if you are using Discord on a PC or laptop like I do, when you activated the two-factor authentication, you were prompted to download a text file containing a set of backup codes for you to use in case you lost access to your authentication app. So chances are you might have that file saved somewhere on your computer. To find it, just open your file explorer and search for Discord backup. If you did save this file previously, you should see a text document called Discord_backup_codes. So open it and there they are. These are your backup codes for your Discord account. The fourth thing you should try is, well, there is no fourth step. What I normally recommend to all of my viewers asking me how to recover this or that account is to contact that website support team. Most of the times they will be able to reset your 2FA once you provide some kind of proof of identity. so you can access your account again. But this is not the case for Discord, or at least not at this point in time. I did try to contact their support team to see if they can reset my 2FA, and apparently they cannot do that. So if none of these free solutions helped you gain access to your Discord account, well, you might need to open a new one. If you did manage to recover your account, I'm happy for you, but this won't prevent you from having issues with the two-factor authentication in the future. Reason why, I strongly recommend you to watch my next video where I talk about the Google Authenticator app, so you can find out how to set it up and how to use it properly.